Hi, let's continue chapter 1, What is Psychology? Today we are going to do topics which are 3 in number. First, evolution of psychology, then evolution of psychology in India, and the themes of psychology. Let's start with topic 1, which is evolution of psychology. Now let me tell you here that evolution is the same concept as a school of thought, as approaches, as theoretical viewpoints or theoretical perspectives. Now, various psychologists have given different viewpoints about the concept of what is psychology. That is what we are going to study here in the history of psychology or the evolution of psychology. Let's start with first school of thought, which is structuralism. Now, every school of thought will have a country in which they originated, the name of the psychologist, and the concept and the methodology by which they studied it. First school of thought is structuralism. Now, as the name suggests, structure is basically talking about the structure of the mind, structure of the consciousness, or structure of the thoughts. Now, since psychology developed in Germany in Leipzig when it separated from philosophy in 1876, when it started with psychological experiments, psychological laboratories to become a science, this is what happened in the first school of thought. So, the name of the psychologist or the founder is Wilhelm Wundt, who developed the first psychological laboratory in Germany. So, this school of thought belongs to Germany. Structuralism basically deals with the factors or the constituents of the mind, of the consciousness, of the soul. Now, this is where it takes advantage of the method of introspection. Introspection, again, as the name suggests, a particular participant or the person to whom the experiment is being done, he has to explain his own mental processes. Then we move on to the next school of thought, which is functionalism. Now, as structuralism was dealing with the structure of the mind, this school of thought talks about the functions of the mind. If we talk about what purpose does the consciousness serve, my consciousness, my awareness, what function, what purpose does it serve? That is basically to adapt to the environment, to deal with the environment or the people around me, situations around me effectively. This school of thought developed in US, America by William James. And then we move on to the third school of thought, which is Gestalt psychology. Now, if I show you the pen like this, and if I show you the pen with its separate parts, you will not really understand its separate parts like this. You will understand the total picture that I give you. If I show you a triangle which is broken into separate parts, your mind will still put a total picture into it and give you a triangle. If you look at the Diwali lights, separate lights, separate bulb light up separately, but you still look at the pattern of Diwali lights. When we go to a cinema hall, we look at the screen, it is not separate screen, separate projection, separate scenes projected, we look at it as a separate combined scene. That is the Gestalt school, which says that we are not talking about the structures, we are talking about the total part. When we have the separate parts, the totality loses its meaning, totality loses its significance. So, this school of thought says whole is more than the sum of the parts. This school of thought was given by Kohler, Kofka and Wertheimer. Now, let me put it here that you will find these names a little difficult initially because these are Western names. And these are not Indian names, so a little time is required for you to understand, read up again and again, listen to it again and again, you will remember them. That is the Gestalt school. Let's move on to the fourth school of thought, which is behaviorism. Now, this school of thought is given by John Watson primarily. He was the main person. Behavior is what it studies. Now, Watson was very particular about psychology being a science, so he basically focused on scientific, measurable, observable data. Whatever you can see, what is going on here is what you can't see. So, that was totally rejected. What you can see outside was what you can measure, and therefore Watson considered that. So, stimulus outside, my response, stimulus response association is what Watson scientifically wanted to study. Next school of thought is psychoanalysis. Now, this is a very famous school of thought. It is used in a lot of other disciplines as well. This was given by a very famous person, Sigmund Freud. All of you must have heard his name also. Now, this school of thought says a very different point of view. It says you analyze the psyche through the unconscious. Now, what you can hear right now is the conscious. What is not, you're not aware of, something very painful, very traumatic that the mind has chosen to forget. That is the unconscious part of you. Such needs, such desires are in the unconscious. That is what governs our behavior without even us being aware of it. That is what Freud talked about. He also said you can cure diseases by understanding what is there in the unconscious. That is what was said by Sigmund Freud. Next school of thought, humanistic approach. Now, this view of thought is very different from all the others again, and especially from psychoanalysis, because psychoanalysis was talking about a negative view of human being. Humanist, as the name suggests again, talks about human beings as being very positive, as being very good, as being very goal-directed. So, they can easily work towards their free will, what they think is right, because they are good. That is what Abraham Maslow and Carl Rogers talked about. Next school of thought and the last one is cognitive psychology. Now, cognition, if we talk about a term, is the same as mental processes, that is all the processes of the mind, like thinking, like decision making, like memory. All these are functions of the mind which we call as cognition. Now, this school of thought was given by Jean Piaget and Vygotsky, a Russian psychologist. They said the way people think, the way people remember, the way people use different mental processes is what we study in cognitive psychology. We also try and understand how a human being constructs actively the data around. So, use of the mind in actively constructing the data around. That is the last school of thought. Let's move on to the next topic, development of psychology in India. Now, we've already done development of psychology all over the world. Let's come to hometown India. Now, here when we look at the tabular form, the first development in when a psychologist wanted to bring psychology from Western countries to India, it wanted India also to have its own psychology. So, it started developing and working on right from before independence. When we look at the pre-independence era, 1915, this was the establishment of psychology, Department of Psychology by Professor N. N. Sen Gupta. This was in Calcutta. He was one of the first persons. He also developed psychology, applied psychology in India. Then we move on to 1922, where establishment of Indian Psychological Association by Professor G. Bose, and also psychology expanded to Mysore, Patna, Bhubaneswar, Allahabad, all these areas as well. Then we move on to 1947 to 1960s era. In fact, when we talk about this, a person named, a researcher named Durganand Sinha, he has developed, he has given in his book four important stages in which psychology developed in India. First stage, 1940 up till 1947, where psychology was being adapted from the Western model. Psychology was trying to have its own identity. Then from 1947 to 1960, it expanded into different branches. It also tried to link itself to the Indian context. After 60 to 70, it tried to solve various problems in India dealing with psychology. So, psychology was applied, problem-oriented research, applied research was also taken up, research of different kinds where you can apply and solve problems of people was taken up. Last phase is indigenization of education, which was after 1970s, post-1970s. Here, they were trying to fit in psychology within the Indian socio-cultural framework, and also it was trying to bring about its own approaches. Indigenization of psychology started, Indian approaches started. Also, it tried to link psychology, apply it to different fields. So, this is where psychology was becoming interdisciplinary. Last topic for today that we have is themes of psychology. Now, when we talk about the themes, we have four basic themes here. Themes again talks about how is psychology applied, what are the areas in which psychology is applied. So, themes, the first theme is the same as the definition, which is psychology studies science like other sciences, and it also studies mental processes. Now, this is where we talk about the concept of basic psychology, where psychology of different kinds, branches of different kinds are studied, and also through the scientific method. That is what the first theme talks about, which we are all aware of. Second theme deals with B is equal to F, which is behavior is equal to a function of person and environment. B is equal to F in bracket, person and environment. So basically, psychology is dealing with two aspects. One is what is there inherited in genes. When people are born, they carry their genes from their ancestors. That is the natural part of it, which we cannot alter. It sets a limit, and thereafter you can always change the environmental aspect of it. Genes are automatically set. So one is the natural genetic basis, and the other is what environment offers you, the kind of conditions that you're born in, family environment, parenting, schooling, all these aspects help you groom yourself from the natural aspect. So these are the two aspects which psychology studies: person, that is the genes, and the environment, that is what is there around you, the conditions around you. Third theme that we talk about is all behavior is caused. That basically means that every behavior has a reason. So one behavior can have one reason, one factor influencing that. Let's say a person is very attached to his mother. Now that has to have a reason. Maybe the mother has really done a lot for the child. The mother also reciprocates. That's a cause. Similarly, another aspect could be when a child is not studying so well. What could be the reasons for that? So complex factors will come in here. Lots of factors will come in here. So behavior is caused by simple factor or by multiple factors. Fourth theme that we talk about is psychology is developing in a cultural context. When we study a culture, let's say a culture of India and a culture of America, the two are very different. So when we study one, a particular action of a person can have a different meaning in a different culture. Somebody waving can have a different meaning in another culture. So therefore, you have to be very particular about the different cultures to understand how people are born and brought up in different cultures and how their psychology develops. The last theme talks about the application of psychology to different cultural contexts. Now here, the purpose of psychology and understanding psychology is not just to read it up, but also to use it in your daily life to modify your behavior for the better. So this is where psychology is an applied field, applied to different areas, and that is where we can make use of using psychology in different practical settings to help you grow into a better human being. Let's continue with this table, which is a part of both evolution of psychology and evolution of psychology in India. Let's look at this table. First, 1879, structuralism as a school of thought developed. 1890, William James, functionalism continued 1895. 1900, Freud did his research on psychoanalysis. Surprisingly, he was not a psychologist, he was a general physician. 1904, Ivan Pavlov won a Nobel Prize in his research on dogs. This was a behaviorist who was not a psychologist again, he was also a physician. 1905, the first intelligence test was developed. 1916, Calcutta department, we've already done. 1920, Germany, a Gestalt school, we've already done. 1922, Indian Scientific Association was developed. 1924, Indian Psychological Association, Psychoanalytic Association. 1924, again, a behaviorist, Watson, this we've already covered. 1928, Professor N.N. Sen Gupta, Calcutta University. 1951, Humanism as a school of thought took over. 1953, Skinner, who was a behaviorist, also worked on it. 1955, Nimhans was opened up. This is a mental hospital in Bangalore where a lot of patients are dealt with, a lot of degrees of psychology are also dealt with. 1962, Ranchi department, Ranchi hospital was opened up for psychology. 1973, Lorenz won a Nobel Prize for his research. 1978, decision-making research was done by Simon, again a Nobel Prize won. 1981, again, Sperry did a research, won a Nobel Prize for split brain experiment. 1997, the latest one, NBRC, National Brain Research Commission. And last, 2002, Kahneman won a Nobel Prize for his research on judgment. So today we've done all these topics. Let me summarize quickly. First topic that we've done is the evolution of psychology in India. Then we have done historical perspective in general. And then we've done the various themes of psychology. And this is what we end up the chapter with today. Thank you.